नमस्कार फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन मल्टीसिम ट्यूटोरियल। इन टुडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न हाउ टू प्रिपेयर अ ब्रिज रेक्टिफायर इन टू द मल्टीसिम। सो लेट्स बिगिन द सेशन। टू स्टार्ट विथ विल गो टू दिस कंपोनेंट टूल बार एंड फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल विल स्टार्ट विथ सोर्सेस। सो फ्रॉम बेसिक विल गेट द गो टू सोर्सेस। फ्रॉम पावर सोर्सेस we'll get AC power, then we'll get ground. Now from diodes will bring 1N4007 diode. Why we are taking this 1N4007 diode? Because it's on an average very famous and almost used in many applications, so that is why we are using. Otherwise there are so many varieties of diode, so much of diode is available, right? You can bring any of this diode, there is no issue in that. Then from basics we'll get a load resistance. So we got the component we want. Now the easy trick to prepare bridge rectifier. First of all, turn it round. So by pressing Ctrl plus R, you can rotate it by 90 degree. So this is D1 diode, Ctrl C, Ctrl V, D2 diode, Ctrl V, D3 diode, Ctrl V, D4 diode. So first of all, you need to arrange all these four diodes into H formation. This is the easiest way to prepare this diode. Just arrange this four diode into bridge formation. Control R this resistance and place it here. So when you place these diodes in H formation, then it will be very much easier for you to connect and to remember how to prepare the circuit diagram for bridge rectifier. So connect all these diodes together. So we have connected all the diode. Now connect this resistance in this manner. So extreme two ends is for DC and the ends which are in between the diodes is for AC. So this is the circuit diagram for the bridge rectifier. Now what do we need to do is, we just need to connect this ground, right? So we have connected this ground. Now if we want to measure the voltage and current flowing through this, we need a scope. So get the scope from this instrument toolbar, right hand side over here. So here we have a scope. In one scope we can observe two waveforms. So what we'll do, we'll use one scope for output voltage and current measurement, and the another scope is for inputs voltage and current measurement. So just Ctrl C and V and we'll get two scopes, right? Now let's make some place for scope. Drag it a little down. Scope can be placed properly, right? Now to measure voltage, we'll connect this across the supply, and to measure current, we'll go to simulate instruments and we'll get current probe. If you want to learn about this current probe, I have prepared a separate video for that. You can watch that video and learn how to use this current probe and how to measure current using this current probe. Now let's connect the another scope. So this is the circuit. Now we'll make the necessary changes. We want to apply 220 volt and 50 hertz of supply, and we want to name it as VS. So it's our 220 volt 50 hertz. Now this 14007 diode's capacity is 1 ampere. So at max you can allow 1 ampere of current passing through this diode. So arrange the value of resistance accordingly. So we are planning to set resistance of 350 ohm, which ensures that on any moment current will not increase the limit of 1 ampere. So this is how you can prepare the circuit for bridge rectifier and measure the voltage and current's waveform for input and output. If you want to learn how this circuit works, then I have prepared a separate video for that, which is next into this playlist. So just go there and watch the video working of the bridge rectifier or how the bridge rectifier works. So thanks for watching this video. Bye bye.